Gold is very useful as a soldering material when it's used with alloys. They have very high melting points, and for that reason, sometimes the gold-based alloys are referred to as brazing alloys, because brazing alloys are the next step above solder alloys in terms of their melting point. The most common alloys of gold are, one for example, is 80% gold, 20% tin, which melts at 280 degrees C. There's another one called 88 gold 12 germanium that melts at 356 degrees C. And there's also some gold silicon alloys that are used for soldering to bare silicon dye. Gold is very noble, and part of that nobility is that it resists oxidation, which lends itself to fluxless soldering. And if you're not a soldering person, that may not mean much to you, but if you are, you will appreciate the ability to do soldering without the use of a flux. It is also, again, due to the nobility of gold, it resists corrosion, and that makes it useful for harsh environments, like if there's an acid involved or something like that. Gold forms very hard, strong alloys. That may be counterintuitive because pure gold itself is so soft, but when you alloy it, it becomes much stronger. For example, 80% gold, 20% tin, has a tensile and shear strength of 40,000 PSI. It also has very high electrical and thermal conductivity. So gold, extremely useful, especially in soldering and solder alloys. We have these alloys. If you'd like to know more about them, please contact us at askus@indium.com.